All right, so when we take a step back and look at the latest round of economic data, the market seems to like the latest jobs report, but what's your take on where we are with the economic data as we're still near all-time highs?
Absolutely. Well, if you think about economic data as it comes in, so week by week, month by month, the signal can be pretty confusing. We have the manufacturing sector and corporate profits looking weaker, and the consumer sector doing really, really well. For us, it's all about putting that economic data in sequence. And so if you look at the way an economic cycle normally transgresses, we would expect the consumer sector to be the last domino in the round to topple. So it's great news that the consumer still doing well. It's two-thirds of the U.S. economy, but it is the thing that tends to turn last. And so the fact that earlier dominoes, again, manufacturing, corporate profits, have already weakened tells us that risks are skewed to the downside. Mm.
Well, let's talk a little bit more about the corporate profits. If you could break that down just a little bit more for us, why is that a concern for you heading into the new year?
Well, if you think about it, if a company is making money, then they don't have to be quite as worried about risks, things like trade wars or really anything that would happen in their supply chains or in their business. When those profit margins are decelerating, for example, or looking weaker, then companies are more susceptible to risks in the economy. And so when we look to 2020, seeing those corporate profits looking weak is something that we're really concerned about when it comes to asset valuations.
So for the corporate profits, we're seeing downward revisions, but still positive growth year over year?
That's right. So downward revisions, not just in earnings that we're seeing with companies, but also in economic profits. That takes some of the potential manipulations or changes that companies can make in their accounting. And that's really where we see the potential risk, that vulnerability to economic shock.